مایک پومپئو وزیر خارجه آمریکا، نیویورک، 3 مرداد 99. من در نامه‌ای به دبیر کل و رئیس شورای امنیت آنها را مطلع کردم که آمریکا همه تحریم‌های سازمان ملل را که تعلیق شده بود برمی‌گرداند. این پروسه 30 روز پس از امروز به فعال شدن تحریم‌ها منجر می‌شود. این تحریم‌ها همچنین تحریم‌های تسلیحاتی را تمدید می‌کند. آمریکا هرگز اجازه نخواهد داد بزرگترین دولت حامی تروریست در جهان آزادانه به خرید و فروش هواپیما، تانک، موشک و دیگر سلاح‌های متعارف دست بزند.
Just a few minutes ago, I delivered letters to both the UN Secretary General Guterres and to the President of the Security Council. I notified them that the United States is initiating the restoration of virtually all UN sanctions on Iran lifted under UN Security Council Resolution 2231. This process will lead to those sanctions coming back into effect 30 days from today. Our message is very, very simple. The United States will never allow the world's largest state sponsor of terrorism to freely buy and sell planes, tanks, missiles, and other kinds of conventional weapons. These UN sanctions will continue the arms embargo. I'm pleased to say, too, that these restored sanctions will also reimpose accountability for other forms of Iranian malign activity that the authors of the nuclear deal foolishly downplayed. Iran will again be prohibited from ballistic missile testing. Iran will be back under sanctions for ongoing nuclear activities, such as the enrichment of nuclear material that could be applied to a nuclear weapons program. This is happening, of course, at a moment when Iran is refusing to allow the IAEA to inspect sites suspected of undeclared nuclear activity that were formerly part of Iran's nuclear weapons program. President Trump and this administration have discarded the fiction that the regime merely seeks a peaceful nuclear program. We will never allow the Islamic Republic of Iran to have a nuclear weapon. Our actions today, too, should come as no surprise to anyone. Our team has made every diplomatic effort over now almost 2 years to renew this arms embargo. I want to thank the Dominican Republic for standing with us in this effort. Our friends in Germany, France, and the United Kingdom, the E3, all told me privately that they don't want the arms embargo lifted either. And yet, today, in the end, they provided no alternatives, no options. No country but the United States has had the courage and conviction to put forward a resolution. Instead, they chose to side with the Ayatollahs. Their actions endanger the people of Iraq, of Yemen, of Lebanon, of Syria, and indeed their own citizens as well. In stark contrast, the Gulf Cooperation Council nations deserve praise for showing courage and unity in warning about the danger from Iran. 2 weeks ago, Bahrain, Kuwait, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and the United Arab Emirates sent a letter to the Security Council urging a renewal of the arms embargo before it expired in October. As Iran's neighbors, they know better than anyone else the havoc that Iran could create with these weapons. Look, the world, and especially our European friends on the Security Council, should have heeded their words. America won't join in this failure of leadership. America will not appease. America will lead. The leadership begins with recognizing the Islamic Republic of Iran for what it truly is, a theocratic, revolutionary, brutish regime that will not voluntarily seek peace or make life better for the Iranian people. The one-sided, foolish nuclear deal didn't bring security for America. It didn't bring stability to the Middle East, nor did it moderate the regime's behavior. And it never can. It never will. Today's actions puts additional pressure on Iran to behave like a normal country and to come back to the bargaining table. We call on the international community to join us in crafting a stronger deal that addresses the full range of Iran's malign behavior and protects people of all nations that simply want to live free from Iranian predation. He said, look, since 1985 alone, the Iranian regime has conducted terrorist operations across Europe. It's hijacked commercial jets, its bombings, murdered innocent Europeans. It's conducted assassinations of dissidents in Europe, plots to blow up Jewish synagogues. This is all in Europe by the Iranians. Does it make any sense for them to have more weapons? We should not forget that just this year, they took down a commercial airliner. This is not a nation is capable of or trustworthy to be able to buy and sell weapon systems. And so I just urge the whole world to unite. We have every capacity under 2231 to do this, and we'll continue this effort. We're going to make sure that this arms embargo doesn't come back in place. President, in May of 2018, made a decision that we would no longer comply with the political commitments attached to the JCPOA. But go read paragraphs 10 through 12 of the 2231. They're completely separate. We provided no notice to the UN, right, when we withdrew, because it wouldn't have made any sense to provide notice. 2231 is completely independent. Indeed, I thought it'd be worthy to take just a moment to read you what the State Department, the United States State Department, told me when I was a member of Congress back in 2015. I asked this very question. This is written, this is signed by the Assistant Secretary of Legislative Affairs at the State Department, dated November 19th of 2015. They said everything, this is that, the Obama, Kerry, Biden State Department. They said the following. They said everything in the JCPOA and its annexes are commitments Iran made and must keep to remain in compliance. If Iran breaks these commitments, the United States can snap back both unilateral and UN sanctions. Okay. This, look, just it's important to emphasize this. 2231 gave every one of the participant states the right to execute snapback unconditionally. Its Security Council resolutions can only be changed by subsequent Security Council resolutions. And so we think this is really straightforward. We think this is very simple. These UN Security Council resolutions will come back into place 31 days from now, and the United States will vigorously enforce them. The Security Council resolution is very plain, very simple, very straightforward. We know precisely how it will proceed, and so it's not a matter for anger or frustration. It's just we'll follow the rules of the UN Security Council, and that will lead to the sanctions being reimposed 31 days from now. We have every confidence that when these sanctions snap back, that every nation will execute them. That's your obligation as a member of the United Nations to do that, and we have every expectation that every Security Council member will do that.
بیانیه مشترک انگلستان، فرانسه و آلمان. به گزارش سایت دولت انگلستان، سه کشور انگلستان، فرانسه و آلمان روز پنجشنبه در یک بیانیه مشترک گفتند نمی توانند از اقدام آمریکا برای احیای تحریم‌های سازمان ملل علیه رژیم ایران حمایت کنند. آنها اعلام کردند ما از رژیم ایران می خواهیم به منظور حفظ توافق تمامی اقدامات ناسازگار با تعهدات هسته‌ای خودش را به عقب برگردانده و بدون تأخیر به پایبندی کامل توافق برگردد. سه کشور افزودند همانطور که ما تا به حال در مقاطع مختلف از جمله در بیانیه مورخ 19 ژوئن اعلام کرده ایم، ما به ویژه با توجه به اقدامات بی‌ثبات کننده رژیم ایران که بی‌وقفه ادامه دارند، از تبعات انقضای تحریم‌های تسلیحاتی علیه رژیم ایران نگرانی‌های جدی داریم. ترویکای اروپا مصمم به یافتن پاسخ‌های مناسب برای این چالش هاست و به همکاری با تمامی اعضای شورای امنیت و طرف‌های ذی‌نفع برای حرکت در مسیر رو به جلو در جهت حفظ فضای دیپلماسی بیشتر ادامه می‌دهد. تلاش‌های ما در جهت حفظ مرجعیت و تمامیت شورای امنیت سازمان ملل و پیشبرد امنیت و ثبات منطقه خواهد بود. روسیه و چین درباره مکانیسم ماشه به سود رژیم آخوندی موضع گیری کردند. سفیر روسیه در سازمان ملل واسیلی نبنزیا به خبرنگاران گفت ما این اقدام را به منزله مکانیسم ماشه محسوب نمی کنیم. فقط کشوری که در توافقنامه 2015 باقی باشد می تواند از مکانیسم ماشه استفاده کند. وزارت خارجه چین اعلام کرد درخواست آمریکا پایه قانونی ندارد و سخنگوی دفتر نمایندگی چین در سازمان ملل گفت آمریکا به علت اینکه دیگر عضو برجام نیست نمی تواند از شورای امنیت خواستار فعال کردن مکانیسم ماشه شود.